Hello YouTube, how's everyone doing? It's Professional here. So today I got another Reddit Online video for you guys, and this is a pretty important video, and I have made a petition in order to try to convince Rockstar to try to revert the daily challenges to what they were in the past. And if you agree with me, please like this video, share this video, and also share the petition and sign the petition. I don't normally tell people, you know, share my videos, but for this one, it's really important because, you know, the more likes it gets, it does help the algorithm and does help recommend the video to more people. The reason that I want this video to get a lot of attention so that Rockstar reverts the daily challenges to what they were in the past in Reddit Online. Now, as you guys know, a few days before the update came out on Reddit Online, the Bounty Hunter expansion, we had gotten this message from Rockstar if you tried to log into Reddit Online. And this message would basically tell you that Rockstar was now capping the streaks. So in the past, people could go past a 28-day streak on daily challenges in Reddit Online. And past, you know, day 21, you would be making 0.50 gold per challenge. At day 28, you would get a free treasure map, but a lot of people didn't care about this. They cared more about maintaining the streak past 21 days, because you could maintain a streak for hundreds of days. There was people that I knew that had daily challenge streaks that were going well over 300 days, and all you basically had to do is just sign into the game for less than 5 minutes, do one daily challenge, or play even more if you wanted, but you just needed to play one daily challenge, and you would keep the streak, and you would be making 0.50 gold per challenge, and then you would make additional bonuses if you completed all the base daily challenges and then the roll daily challenges. These daily challenges were amazing. They were great. And we've had the same system in place for a year and a half. For over a year and a half, we've had the same system in place. And then out of nowhere, Rockstar tells us that they're capping the streaks. Now when it gets up to 28 days, it's going to automatically reset. And this is what it's been doing. And this is devastating to a lot of players that have had huge, big streaks on this game. These streaks mean a lot to a lot of players. It's one of the reasons that people log in every day. And if those streaks are gone, people don't maintain them past 28 days, you're going to have a lot of people that are not going to log into the game anymore. And on top of that, it gets even worse because when the update did come out, Rockstar capped the daily challenges in half. So not only did they get rid of the streaks, no more streaks past 28 days, all daily challenges were cut in half. So here on the screen I have above, this is how much we used to make in the past. So on day 1 through day 7, you would be making 0.20 gold per challenge. And if you completed all 7 of the base daily challenges, you would be getting a 0.60 gold bonus on top of that. There was also an additional 9 roll challenges, which, you know, these were expanded with the Frontiers Pursuits update for Bounty Hunter, Collector, Trader challenges. They were also expanded with the Moonshiner in December of 2019, so we got Moonshiner challenges, and the Naturalist in July of 2020. So we had gotten a lot more daily challenges as well, and they were nice, and a lot of people enjoyed them. On week 2, day 8 through 14, you would be making 0.30 gold per challenge, and then you would be also getting a 0.90 gold bonus for completing all 7 of the regular ones or completing 9 of the roll challenges. On day 15 through day 21, you would be making 0.40 gold per challenge. And then on top of that, you would also be getting 1.20 gold bars back if you got the bonus. And then on the 4th week, on day 22 to whatever day in the future, because you could keep the streak indefinitely at this point, you would be getting 0.50 gold per challenge. This was a great way to earn gold. A lot of people did it, and now that Rockstar is cutting this, a lot of people feel like the reason that Rockstar cut this, including myself, is so that they could sell more gold bars in Reddit Online. Because they claim that this is daily challenge balancing. If you actually look at the, if you look at Rockstar's newswire, there's patch notes in relation to the update. It says daily challenge balancing. And even though they're claiming it's daily challenge balancing, the price of gold bars has stayed the same. So the price of gold bars not decreased at all, but yet the amount of gold bars that you can make back has been cut so much. And Rockstar tried to justify this by saying, oh, we've increased the payouts on some free mode missions if you take 5 minutes longer. We've also added the ability to transfer roll XP from the Bounty Hunter into gold, but that's so minuscule. It's 0.50 gold, you get 500 XP back, and you get a few hundred dollars, but that takes hours and hours of grinding. It was much easier just to do a few daily challenges and you'd make a few gold bars in a day. Now with this new system, it feels like Rockstar is just trying to push microtransactions as much as possible, and I'm going to use Rockstar's own words against them, and this is why I advise everyone to sign this petition, share this petition, because Rockstar claims, we listen to fan feedback. That's what they've constantly been claiming. We have, you know, the feedback page. Submit your feedback to us. Well, this is feedback that we are submitting to you, Rockstar, and we want the daily challenges to be reverted to what they were in the past. If you want to prove that you listen to fan feedback, you listen to your fans, consider this, and consider reverting the daily challenges to what they were in the past. Let people maintain daily challenges past 28 days and bring back the original payouts. Right now, I am on the last week of my daily challenges, and I'm making 0.25 gold per challenge when I should instead be making 0.50 gold per challenge. And when it gets up to 28 days, well, guess what? It's going to be reset. So, my words back to Rockstar, and I'm using their own words against them. If you want to prove that you listen to fan feedback, change this. Please sign my petition, guys. Help this petition get spread around. Help it get a lot of signatures. And I know what some people are going to tell me in the comments. Your petition is going to go nowhere. Your petition is going to do nothing. I understand that. I understand that the petition is probably not going to do anything, but it's worth a try. I'm at least trying to do something here. And I'm using Rockstar's own words against him. You listen to fan feedback, Rockstar? Well, consider this. And if a lot of people sign this petition, thousands and thousands of people, and people spam that petition on Rockstar's feedback page, and Rockstar does not even acknowledge it at all, that's pretty much proof right there in their face that they don't listen to fan feedback. And I'm gonna ask, you know, any Red Dead Online YouTubers and any other YouTubers that want to share my petition and share my original video, feel free to. The more this goes around, the more that it helps to possibly fix this issue that we've had on Red Dead Online. The only thing that I would ask is to link my original video, but other than that, share my video, post my video wherever you want, post a petition, share it around, sign the petition, like this video. It does help. Hopefully Rockstar does something about this. Please do consider doing something about this, Rockstar, because I like Red Dead Online. I don't hate this game. I play this game a lot, that's why I'm ranked 350 in this game, and I have a lot of money saved up on this game, including gold bars, because I play and enjoy this game. And if you're trying to get people to buy gold bars because you're cutting the daily challenges, that's going to backfire on you. A lot of people are going to stop playing the game. I've already got messages from a lot of people that are really high levels that are not going to play your game anymore because of this. They just feel like the game has been neglected, and they feel like they've been betrayed with what you've done here. It's not fair to the longtime fans of your game that have played for years on this game. This game's been out for 2 years now, that out of nowhere, after having this system for a year and a half since May of 2019, that you're just going to randomly do this, not even tell us ahead of time that they're getting cut in half, only giving us a few days notice the streaks are going to be disabled, and then when the update comes out itself, just throw this in our face like this? Really? Who asked for this? Who asked for this? Who wanted the daily challenges to be cut in half? I certainly didn't. And if you want to sell more gold bars, Rockstar, I understand. You're a business, and you gotta make your money. I get that. I understand. The reason we get free content is because you're hoping that people buy microtransactions. I understand that. But this is not the way to go about it. If you want more people to buy gold bars, you want more people to buy your microtransactions, add more content to your game. Add properties, add house customization, add more roles, add an outlaw role, allow us to rob banks, maybe even, you know, allow us to possibly own trains in the future. I know that seems maybe kind of crazy in the future, but there's so much stuff that they could add to this game. Add new carriages, maybe add the war wagon carriage that we saw in the previous bounty with the turret, allow us to customize that. If you add a ton of new stuff to this game, I guarantee you, a lot of people are gonna buy gold bars. Yes, there will be people that will grind and won't buy gold bars, but there will be plenty of people that will still buy gold bars, and then everyone is happy that way. But simply cutting the daily challenges like this and expecting that people are gonna keep playing your game, it's not gonna happen. I love this game, and I want this game to succeed, but this is the wrong way to do it, Rockstar. So I really hope that they consider looking at this petition, and like I said, feel free to share this video, post this video. I'm sorry for my rant there, guys, but I'm just upset with what Rockstar has done in this game, and I hope this petition does something. Hopefully, we can get this petition even to 50,000 signatures. If we can, I think that would be really good. But let me know what you guys think down below, and please do consider signing the petition and liking the video and sharing it, because like I said, it does help. Thank you everybody for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Take care, everyone.